Hello, I want to play something for you guys that was just sent to me. I love it, and I just want to share it. Modern women, westernized women, true woman, true man. I don't know what I'm gonna call this, but anyways, take a listen to this with me.
You are in the streets with a woman that you don't have authority over. And this ain't about being the boss or acting like I'm this, that, and the other. When it's real, when you're in the streets with your woman, y'all in danger. If you don't know that, I'm telling you now.
Right.
The streets are crazy. These people out here mixing the Xannies and the perks together. It's wild out here. So y'all need to be ready for what can come and what probably will come. And one of the ways of being ready is you gotta listen to your man, because he's the one who's got to protect you. If you're with a man that you feel like you can't be safe with when you're in the streets, you probably don't need to be with him.
Right.
So if he tells you, look, baby, let's go to the car. I don't want to hear that. No, she better shut up talking to me and all like that. You know
right,
what I'm saying?
Okay, I got you.
You got to be like, yo, I said, let's go. And if
right.
there's any problems after that, you're supposed to leave him.
Before I get into what he was saying, let me give a little prequel. And I believe this guy, I believe he's a comedian, actor. I used to watch, I believe that's the guy from Black Jesus. Anyways, I think that's him. He's a, oh, Corey Holcomb. Isn't that who he is? If it's not, he looks like him, Corey, who was speaking. Okay. Prequel. I would not have had this tool. And I'm talking to the male and females. I would not have had this tool if I wouldn't have had this tool if I kept listening to people around me. I mean, everybody. And I'm talking about, that's what I'm talking about. You know, the good advice that I get are from people that, from strangers. The good advice that I get aren't from people that I see all the time. I mean, every now and then, maybe there's a message sent. Do you understand me? The best messages I have gotten are from complete strangers. Because most of the work is within yourself. And when you're listening to a lot of people, that's how self-sabotage is so high up. Okay? I guess the other part on working on yourself, this is the key in working on yourself, which it sounds easy. And people's like, yeah, I'm gonna start working on myself. It's heavy. And really, people know how heavy it is because it sounds good, but then when it's time for you to do it, you have an excuse on why you didn't do it, or things have just been coming up. But one of the good things about working on yourself is not only stopping the self-sabotage, it's also now, like, if I think, I believe every woman that I have been with has bickered when I felt we need to get out of here, or what he was saying. I think there has been no, well, I'm saying in past relationships, there has been no woman that truly said, okay, this was shocking to me, because I told you guys about this trip I went to. I was Washington, Canada, and I met this girl on a, this woman on a lady, what do I call you? Cause she, I met this, it's an inside joke. Okay, I'm sorry. I'm supposed to be serious right here. So I met this woman on this trip. And, you know, that is the thing. So that is the thing I found out that attracts me, because I've never had it. I never had it. We were in this store. We were in this store, and I didn't feel comfortable. And I said, hey, we can go somewhere else. She didn't question or anything. She looked at me and she can see like this, my eyes is like, she said, let's go. And then we went out. She says, you want to drive? And this is her, her truck, her van or whatever, her A-team van. And, she says, you want to drive? I said, like, I don't know my way around here. She's like, I mean, what do you see? I was like, I'll tell you later. And she's like, you want to drive? I'm like, no, you drive. But, you know, she was all about me completely taking over. I did not know my way around where we were. And that attracted me. that attracts, because I've never had that. And it wasn't about me being the boss. I'm authority, you know. She trusts my feelings. And we just, I mean, just, we only knew each other for a few days. We just met. So that is something I never incorporated in my system. Like he said, leave her. I never did that. I was going to always try to work to keep her. For what? Value. I can't stress that enough, that you need to work on yourself to understand what your value is. For instance, like if I ask you if I can borrow your car, everything is like, I got your attention now, right? Why is the car getting more attention than yourself, right? You're going to want me to sign contracts. Don't go here. I don't want you drive this street. Don't go turn around. If they use the blinker every time, all that, you know, you want all that. Make sure you got the fog lights on when it's foggy. Make sure you got the, all that. You're doing all that. Well, what about yourself? What about yourself? I remember when I was younger. Oh, I got two stories. When I was younger, I would connect with people, and then it would be people like my family who, I say, Grandma, can I go over there? And she had that look. And, you know, I'm young. I don't know what. I think she's thinking I'm about to do some trouble. I'm going to be all right, you know. Hold on. Right? I'm thinking my grandma. And she was like, if anything happens to him, there's going to be some problems. Right? And so, and even when I was getting a little too wild, they were like, no, we can't do that right now, man. We can't do that right now. Right? I was valued. Okay? Same with in school, where I remember this dude, we never talked. And he was a big Zeus looking dude. And I never put it together. He told me at the end, like graduation, he was like, man, I came because you hilarious, man. I'm like, and everybody kept talking about it. He missed it. Like, you missed what Carlos did and everything. He said he kept coming to school, which then he's just started doing the work and everything. He kept coming to school because he knew I was going to do something crazy. And then there was this one time where, you know, jealousy and the whole thing, and I was being picked on. And he walked by. He was like, I tell you what, you touch this dude, you're going to have to touch me. And, you know, that was it. And that was that. So you are valued. And that's the same thing in relationships, where the best thing to do was not to sit there and stand ground. For what? The best thing to do was, let's go. Even if nothing was going to happen. But I don't know. But let's go. I think the last thing I want to say, ladies, you are a target. It's more than you can even imagine. The nicest guy understand that. Fellas and ladies, you have to understand what the guys have to go through, because with him being with you, he is now the target, right? You must understand that in all sections of emotions. So better safe than sorry, isn't it? I want to be with somebody who doesn't battle me, that I have to prove. And let's just say nothing happens. See, nothing happened. Like he said, leave. I never had that voice that said, leave, you know? I was with a girl, and she had a t-shirt on, so it looked like she was butt naked, because she had just a big t-shirt on, just going to the store real quick. And I understood a little poquito Spanish, and these dudes, I understood what they were saying. So I said, let's go. And it was an argument. And I was the fool. Well, no, I wasn't, because I was responsible. But I was the fool. Yeah, that was a tough one. That's a tough one. Anyways, I'll never be in that situation again, to where that masculine energy was coming out of her and it was overthrowing me. So now I'm stuck there just in case something happens. But I was doing my, like, you make your move, I'll make my move, you know? And yeah, I was going to possibly get into a fight for no reason, you know? So ladies, just understand what we have to go through as men. And also, You are a target, and it's a different type of a power. When you're alone, it's a different type of power than when you're with some other man. Some may say it's stronger even with another man, because now he wants to be the lion to take the mate. It's all sorts of things going on. So isn't it just better to be safe? Isn't it better to be safe than sorry? And let's say you're running late or whatever, like, oh no, we got 10 minutes. Isn't it better to be safe? All right, those are my thoughts.